about whether you want to head out and cut down your own Christmas tree or just take a trip up to the mountain, you will need to make sure you can get there safely.
Yeah, the Portland area saw a lot of snow last year, and if that happens again, you'll want to be ready for winter driving. Tony talks to an expert on traction devices in today's Behind the Wheel.
Yeah, the thing about traction devices is that you want to have them before you need them. But what's the right traction device for you? Well, lots of choices. We'll go through them and see if we can't narrow the choices down and find the right traction device for you.
So this tire right here is a true four-season tire. You can run it year-round, great traction capability. Does have that mountain snowflake designation to it.
Add all of that up, and this all-season tire might be the most convenient traction device to use. The next step up would be a true winter tire, but even without studs, you can't run those year-round.
It's gonna lose a little bit compared to a studded tire on the ice, but still incredibly good compared to a true all-season.
Let's take a look at studded tires.
Yep, this one's a true studded tire. So these metal cleats digging into that ice are gonna stop you just a little bit quicker. So a little more safety involved there when it comes to your extreme winter conditions.
But in Oregon and Washington, you can only run studded tires from November 1st to March 31st. The rest of the year, you'll have to take those tires off and store them. Also,
they tend to cost just as much as a premium studless tire. So cost-effective wise, you're just getting the traction capability.
But they're already on, you know they're there, there's no getting under the car and putting on chains.
Exactly, yep.
Speaking of chains, let's take a look. So here are the chains that strike the fear in many drivers' hearts.
Exactly, exactly.
Not so easy to manage for some people.
Oh yeah, some frozen fingers out in the slush and rain and snow, yeah. Not much fun.
But better traction than a studded tire.
Absolutely. Definitely going to dig you through that deep slush and deep snow way better than a winter tire would do by itself.
And if you buy your chains at Les Schwab but end up not using them, you can return them for a full refund, even if you've done a practice installation.
As long as they're doing it in a dry area, they're just doing a quick test fit on them, they put them back in the bag clean and dry, that's not a problem at all.
That same policy applies to tire socks.
So the sock's kind of a fabric mesh design. These give you great traction when it comes to your compact snow and your ice. The fibers just kind of sink into that snow and ice and melt in there. It's like walking out in the snow with your socks on.
Right, and what's the drawback though for drivers who use tire socks?
They're definitely a lighter duty application, so you're definitely limited to your speeds you can drive.
As you can see, each device has its pros and cons. Add in variables like front-wheel drive, all-wheel drive, and four-wheel drive, and you might find yourself stuck in a snowbank of confusion. Best advice, talk to a pro and let them pull you out into the clear.
My personal choice, I run a studless winter tire. Plus, I carry a pair of the quick fits, so if I do travel in those emergency situations, I've got the extra traction.
And do you call a tech to put those on for you, or do you do it yourself?
Oh, I do it myself. Lots of practice.
All right, lots of choices. Do your research, but by all means, get what you need before you need it when it comes to traction devices. I'm Tony Martinez, Fox 12 Oregon.
Yeah, so many variables there. Some cars don't even take chains. So you check your manual, or better yet, just go talk to a professional at your favorite tire shop. They'll see specifically what you have, what size you're going to need, and hook you up much more quickly than you trying to do it all by yourself there. So it's kind of like doing your own taxes.
You're almost better
having a professional do it. If it gets complex, it gets complex very quickly.
You know what, Tony? I will say we used tire socks for the first time last year.
Uh-huh.
They were awesome.
Yeah.
I mean, I love them, but they do get torn up because, you know, when you go those patches of snow and then not snow, it feels like they get torn up a little bit.
Everything
faster.
Has a trade-off.
Yeah.
So yeah, but good point.
Gotta
easy
go really
though.
Slow in those too.
Yeah.
But yeah, they're really
easy
user friendly for
Thanks,
sure.
Thanks, Tony.